नमस्कार, मैं हूं देवांजलि मोइत्रा। टीम इंडिया के कैप्टन विराट कोहली की शानदार बल्लेबाजी हो या फिर उनकी फिटनेस, पूरी दुनिया उनकी जबरदस्त फैन है। कहते हैं भारत के बाद अगर विराट के सबसे ज्यादा फैंस कहीं हैं तो वो है पाकिस्तान, जहां आम क्रिकेट फैंस के अलावा खुद पाकिस्तानी टीम के ओपनर बल्लेबाज बाबर आजम भी किसी पाकिस्तानी क्रिकेटर को नहीं बल्कि टीम इंडिया के मौजूदा कैप्टन विराट को अपना आदर्श मानते हैं। यहां तक कि भारत के खिलाफ 16 जून को खेले गए मुकाबले से पहले विराट की बल्लेबाजी की क्लिप देखकर तैयारी कर रहे थे, लेकिन इसके बावजूद बाबर आजम अभी तक बल्लेबाजी में कुछ खास कमाल नहीं कर सके, जिसे पाकिस्तान के पूर्व तेज गेंदबाज शोएब अख्तर भड़क गए। दरअसल पिछले कुछ मैचों में देखें तो बाबर आजम शुरुआत तो अच्छी कर रहे हैं, लेकिन कोहली की तरह उसे बड़ी पारी में नहीं बदल पा रहे। इसीलिए अख्तर ने उन्हें सलाह दी है कि अगर वो विराट को अपना आदर्श मानते हैं तो उन्हें विराट की तरह खेलना भी होगा। अख्तर ने अपने YouTube चैनल में कहा, मैं बाबर से कहना चाहता हूं कि अगर तुम विराट कोहली को आदर्श मानते हो तो उसकी तरह खेलना भी सीखो। विराट ने काफी मुश्किल हालात में रन बनाए हैं। आजम को विराट की तरह रन बनाना और उसकी तरह नयापन लाना सीखना होगा। अगर आप विराट, रोहित शर्मा और केन विलियमसन जैसे खिलाड़ियों को देखें तो ये सभी खिलाड़ी अर्धशतक बनाने के बाद रन गति में इजाफा करते हैं। आजम को इन खिलाड़ियों से सीखना चाहिए, उसके पास अधिक शॉट होने चाहिए। अख्तर ने 59 गेंदों में 89 रनों की ताबड़तोड़ बल्लेबाजी करने वाले हैरिस सोहेल की भी तारीफ करते हुए उन्हें बाबर से बेहतर बल्लेबाज बताया। उन्होंने कहा, मैं लगातार कह रहा था कि हैरिस सोहेल को प्लेइंग 11 में जरूर शामिल करना चाहिए, क्योंकि उनमें वो सब खूबियां हैं जो एक बल्लेबाज में होनी चाहिए। साउथ अफ्रीका के खिलाफ उन्होंने दिखाया कि कैसे रन बन सकते हैं, यहां तक कि उन्होंने बाबर आजम से बेहतर खेला। इस पूरे टूर्नामेंट में बाबर आजम की बल्लेबाजी की बात करें तो उन्होंने वेस्ट इंडीज के खिलाफ 22 रन, ऑस्ट्रेलिया के खिलाफ 30 रन, भारत के खिलाफ 48 रन, साउथ अफ्रीका के खिलाफ 69 रनों की पारी खेल चुके हैं। वहीं विराट कोहली ने पाकिस्तान के खिलाफ 77 रन, साउथ अफ्रीका के खिलाफ 18 रन, ऑस्ट्रेलिया के खिलाफ 82 रन, अफगानिस्तान के खिलाफ 67 रनों की पारी खेल चुके हैं। बाबर आजम ओपनिंग करते हैं जबकि विराट कोहली तीसरे नंबर पर बल्लेबाजी करते हैं, लेकिन दोनों के आंकड़े इस वर्ल्ड कप में देखें तो विराट इसमें बेहतर नजर आ रहे हैं। यही वजह है कि शोएब अख्तर ने पाकिस्तानी ओपनर बाबर आजम को सलाह दी है कि अगर वो विराट कोहली को अपना आदर्श मानते हैं तो उनकी तरह खेलना भी सीखें। वैसे जिस तरह से पाकिस्तान इस वर्ल्ड कप की शुरुआत वेस्ट इंडीज के खिलाफ हार से की थी, जिसके बाद से वो संभल नहीं सकी और 6 मैचों में सिर्फ 5 पॉइंट के साथ बांग्लादेश से भी नीचे 7वें नंबर पर मौजूद है। अगर इंग्लैंड अपने बाकी के 3 मुकाबले हार जाती है तभी पाकिस्तान सेमीफाइनल में जगह बना सकता है, जबकि भारत, न्यूजीलैंड और ऑस्ट्रेलिया का टॉप 4 में पहुंचना तय माना जा रहा है।
No, generally when you come to England, you expect these things wherein you know that you are bound to get a few days wherein the weather is going to play spoil sport. But from our point of view, it's not only happened to us, and so far we've been lucky that we haven't had a game affected by the weather. So let's keep our fingers crossed.
Sanjay bhai, first of all, like, when do you expect to, if you can give us a clear picture, when you expect to get Dhawan back, since he's staying back, and now that there could be some rejig in the team because of the injury, like at number 4, like we saw Vijay Shankar batting first at the nets, you were giving him throwdowns, and then DK also batted considerably. So what exactly, how the team combination pans out in this changed circumstances?
I mean, as far as Shikhar is concerned, we'll be observing him, and probably it will take some time. Around the 10th or 12th day, we'll get to know where he stands, and post that we will be in a better position to take a call, because you do not really want to rule out a precious player like Shikhar very straight at the time of when the impact or the injury happened. So we would like to wait and assess after the 10-12 days. As far as the batting order goes, yes, KL moves up at the top of the order, and there are various options that the team management can utilize going into the next game. So obviously Vijay Shankar is going to be an option, and then there are a couple of others as well.
शिखर धवन के कवर के लिए ऋषभ पंत को बुलाने की खबरें चल रही, तो क्या इस तरीके की कोई ऑफिशियल कंफर्मेशन हम लोग को मिलेगा, क्योंकि अभी तक सब हम लोग सोर्सेस
आई थिंक ऑफिशियल मेरे ख्याल से एक मैसेज शायद गया है हमारी तरफ से.
सो फार वी हैवंट रिसीव्ड एनी मैसेज रिगार्डिंग ऋषभ पंत.
So the thing is that in around 10 or 12 days we'll be taking a call on the status of Shikhar, and till that point just to make sure that if and when the replacement is required, and I'm saying if and when, then it is always good to have the replacement player coming in and practicing with the team as a standby.
Is Rishabh Pant is coming or not? Thank you.
Sanjay, you were asked this before, but you think in situations like this where your batsmen can't even get proper practice, bowlers can't bowl at the nets, how difficult is it for the team to keep itself, you know, motivated and prepared, technically prepared for the challenges ahead?
I mean, we've had a fair time to prepare ourselves, because we spent a lot of time before our first match, so that was an advantage. And even whatever opportunities that the players have got so far, everybody's got it to bat and bowl. So from our batting point of view, all the six batsmen, except Kedar, who hasn't got a hit, but all the six batsmen have got a chance to go out there in the middle, and each of them have done really well in the roles or in the positions that they found themselves in. So you've already got our top three batting really well, and they've got runs under their belt. And then you've got Hardik and Mahi and even KL getting game time. So that augurs really well. And it isn't necessary that you come to the nets every day. At times, you know, if you miss practice because of weather or something, that's still fine. Yeah, bowlers, I mean, they are in a good rhythm, and you do not really want to risk bowlers in conditions wherein, you know, the run-up is not really, firm. So you'd rather protect the bowlers rather than bowling them on nets wherein the outfield is slippery.
Sanjay, obviously Shikhar's a loss purely as a batsman for these next few games, but also, can you talk about what that means as far as not having left-hand, right-hand combination, perhaps, and how much of a factor that was in bringing Rishabh over?
Yeah, I mean, it's always an added advantage if you have a right-left combination right at the top of the order. But, I mean, whatever is available to us, we have quality players. So, I mean, Shikhar will definitely be missed in the next 3 to 4 games, but we have a great backup for each position. So with that, we should be able to make it up.
And that's the main reason for Rishabh's being called in?
Yeah, I mean, he bats in the middle order, and obviously being a left-hander helps. And he was named in the standbys as well. So the team management has gone and picked him as per the order.
Sanjay bhai, are you surprised that the Kukabura ball is not swinging as much probably one would have expected, despite having two new balls?
If you see, I mean, the first game that you saw, we played against South Africa, it was a challenging wicket wherein it wasn't easy to bat at all. So it isn't that the conditions have been, you know, one track, but because you saw South Africa being bowled out for 223. And we had to really work hard to get those runs. So there is always something in the wicket. You can't really say that, okay, it's not swinging that much, but the ball is seeming, as you saw in the last game also, because the way Bhuvneshwar Kumar took those wickets in the last couple of overs, he managed to get those wickets because the ball seemed in quite a bit. So there is always something on offer for the bowlers, and even it may not seem from outside, but conditions are always challenging here in England.
Sanjay,
And unlike before, when the openers would go after the bowlers, bang, bang. So this time, Indian players were very restrained in the first 10 overs. Even today, Australia also was very restrained. Is it that kind of bang, bang start is not possible given these conditions and the two new balls factors?
Yeah, it always is a factor here in this part of the world wherein the overhead conditions do make a big difference. So the batsmen have to be a bit circumspect and they have to make those adjustments so that, you know, if the overhead conditions are cloudy, the ball will tend to do something in the air or off the wicket. And with two new balls, you'll always want the top order to show that discipline and, you know, put us in a great position, because what we've seen is that if you are in a good position at the end of 10 or 15 overs past the new ball, wherein, you know, the seam tends to soften a bit up and the ball is not that much harder. So from that point of view, it's always a good strategy. Every opening batsman would like to have that sort of a strategy wherein if the conditions are challenging, you'd always want to give the bowlers the respect and at times bury your ego as well. But if it is nice and sunny and if you're chasing a target, then the strategy could be a little different. The approach of the batsman could be a little different.